Watch, he's moving.
Have you ever tried to roll over a 1,000-pound unconscious elephant seal?
Get her up and over. Take you, hold her nose really tight.
I hadn't either. Take it from me, it's not easy. I'm Wes Larson, a wildlife biologist and lover of the outdoors for as long as I can remember. I'm traveling the country to find the next generation of conservationists, the people on the front lines of the fight to understand our planet and protect the animals we share it with. This time around, I'm on the West Coast, just north of Monterey Bay. I'm meeting up with an elephant seal research team at the University of California, Santa Cruz.
Hey.
Hey, good morning. Good
morning.
Nice to see you. We've got a busy day ahead, so if you could grab one of these jackets, and then we will head up to the beach.
Rachel Holser has been studying elephant seals at the Costa Lab for 4 years, and believes tracking elephant seals could hold the key to a deeper understanding of the ocean as a whole. Our mission this morning is to attach some high-tech tracking tags to an elephant seal. But not just any seal will do.
We are a little bit particular about the animals we put satellite tags on. So an adult female, over 4 years old and under 13 years old, hasn't been tracked before and has been on the beach for nearly a month.
In short, they're looking for a seal that has had her pup and is ready to head back out into the sea. Rachel tells me that there are 7 promising candidates on the beach today, which sounds like a lot to me. But then I see the colony for the first time.
We just kind of rounded this hill and suddenly all these seals are spread out in front of us. One thing that's super surprising is the amount of vocalization that's going on. All the seals kind of talking to each other out here.
It's a lot to take in. The seals are big, loud, and absolutely cover the beach.
Take binos, take a recite data book for sure. And yeah, we'll see what we can find.
As the researchers are fanning out, they're just going seal to seal trying to find the particular female that they're trying to tag today.
With a couple thousand seals on the beach, it's like looking for a needle in a very noisy and potentially dangerous haystack. But it's worth the risk. Turns out, if you want to study the farthest reaches of the ocean, elephant seals are natural deep sea explorers.
They go way out into the middle of the North Pacific and they dive far deeper than anybody thought was possible.
And eventually, Rachel spots the perfect seal.
If you're looking straight down, there's 2 animals back to back. One has a pup nursing on her right side. I think that that is her. We had a good look at her. So we're estimating her mass at about 340 kilograms. So we're gonna pull up a 3.4 cc dose of telazol.
And so you physically just go up and put the needle in them.
Yep, that is how this goes.
It's a big needle. It's to get through all that blubber.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a big male over there. It's actually the alpha male of this colony. So we're kind of just waiting for them to get positioned in a way to where the researchers can go in, sedate the seal, and then attach their tag.
This is the most dangerous part of the research. Rachel has to inject the sedative by hand, and elephant seals can be unpredictable.
They are very dangerous animals. I know they look pretty lazy and sleepy if they're on a beach, but they can move surprisingly quickly and react surprisingly quickly. And the big guys, you know, the males are almost 2 tons, and they can run as fast as a person can run. We spend years being trained to work with them properly.
Did you get the seal stuck?
Yes, we did.
Oh, oh! Just keep a light hand on her nose just in case she pulls that again.
So there's like a bunch of different things going on right now. It's pretty impressive. Teresa's taking these ultrasound measurements with the blubber. These 2 collaborators are putting on the epoxy for this tag that we're attaching to get that oceanographic data. And then on top, we're also attaching a VHF tag. Rachel's kind of organizing everyone and directing everyone to do what they're doing.
Grab another popsicle stick.
Meanwhile, as always, we have all these other seals, so we kind of always have to be keeping an eye on to make sure that no one's coming up and aggressively kind of challenging the group.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Thank you, Patrick. We've been monitoring the population at Año Nuevo for between 3 and 4 decades now. If the elephant seals are not doing well, that means that something is really going sideways down in the food web.
But we got another seal kind of creeping back here. All right. So yeah, one of the really cool things about these tags is they're actually recording oceanographic information with them. All sorts of things that they would normally record with like a really expensive research vessel, they're using these seals kind of as that research vessel.
And elephant seals make exceptionally good research vessels. After they leave the colony, they swim out into the Pacific for thousands of miles, diving over a mile below the surface. And all the while, the tags will be collecting data. What you end up with is a three-dimensional profile of the ocean. That is, if all goes as planned.
It's just so crazy to have like this happening 20 feet away, 10 feet away, as we're working on the seal.
At times, it reminded me of being in an ER.
Half CC cat.
At others, it was like being on another planet surrounded by hostile aliens.
One thing that's really interesting is this kind of like matador act that they have going on. It's just a tarp. I mean, if the thing wanted to come through, it totally can. So at all points, we have to be ready to kind of back off and run away if one of these seals kind of crosses that threshold of safety.
But through the chaos, the team gets it done, deploying three different tags and giving the seal a full checkup.
All right, you guys can go ahead and roll her on Teresa's cow. Okay, go ahead. Good breath. Go ahead and pull it.
So far, so good.
With the science complete, there's one important step left, waiting for our seal to wake up.
We'll stay nearby so that if a male decides to try and mate with her, we can prevent it. We're fully responsible for the well-being of the animal until she is capable of taking care of herself. So it looks like our female's doing really well. She's recovering nicely. She's moved back into the group, and hopefully in about 3 days, she'll head off to sea and give us lots of awesome data.
Looking out at the colony, it's hard to imagine that 100 years ago, elephant seals nearly disappeared.
They did almost go extinct back in the early 1900s. Once the seal was protected and hunting was no longer permitted, they rebounded and they have been spreading ever since.
And now you guys are using them in all these kind of new novel ways to like learn more about the ocean, to protect other species.
Yeah, absolutely.
I found that conservation success can sometimes be as simple as changing perceptions. Rachel and her team have shown that an animal that appears to just lie around on a beach is actually an incredible traveler and athlete. And by harnessing their power, we are able to gain a deeper understanding of the ocean. It makes me wonder how else we could be working with wildlife to protect the planet that we all share.